I got a comment recently asking me how to make realistic looking rock textures. Well, not necessarily realistic, but rock textures or stone textures, any kind of texture that has a kind of bump mapping or some kind of rough looking surface. And I figured it would be a good idea to do a tutorial on that, because I do get a couple of comments like that. So, hey guys, welcome back to TutsByKai. I'm Kai, and today we are back in Blender once again. We're going to be deleting the default cube lamp. Actually, we can leave the lamp, to be honest, today. And the camera one on my numpad to go in the front-facing view. As always, Shift A, or go over here to Create and hit Camera. Add that back in, middle mouse button to pan around my scene, drag the camera back behind the grid, and zero on my camera to go into the camera's view. Now all that's done, we are going to be adding in an icosphere. So we're going to add in the icosphere, and off on the right hand side over here in the modifiers tab, we're going to add in, we're going to drag that up a little bit more. In the modifiers tab, we're going to add a subdivision surface, boom, and we're going to bump that up to 3 on the view and the render. And in tools, we're going to turn on smooth shading so we can see that smooth, luscious circle. You know, we might even go with 4. Let's go all the way up to 4. You can only go up to 4. We can go up to 6. Yes, that's correct. So we'll go up to 4 for the icosphere, and we're going to hit tab mode. We can hit that little triangle right there, get that to form onto the sphere. So first things first, we're going to scale that up a little bit and move our camera G, Y. Hit the S key to scale, by the way. S is scale. And we're going to hit this little triangle and split our window into 2 with our, you know, we'll do it sideways. I never do it sideways. So we're going to click and drag that, and we'll split it in half this way. I never do it sideways anymore. We're going to get rid of this tab because we don't need that. So we're just going to drag that closed. And we're going to change this left-hand side or the right-hand side, whatever side you want to. I don't really care. it doesn't really matter. We're going to hit this cube, and we're going to change this to the node editor. And get rid of that right there. Boom. So now we have our node set up already. To get all nodey, we're going to add in some lights. So we're going to... box left mode. We're going to add in some lights. So with our lamp selected, we're going to select the sun. We're going to change the cycles render, by the way. Because cycles is best for nodes. All right. So now we're all set up. Okay, here we go. We're all set up with our cube, with our sphere selected. We're going to add new material. And first things first, we're going to get rid of that diffuse texture because we don't need it right now. And the first thing we're going to do is we're going to add, and we're going to go shader, texture, Voronoi texture, Voronoi. And with our Voronoi texture, we're going to add another texture, and that's going to be a noise texture. Boom. Plop that down right there. Sorry if it sounds like I'm kind of going a little bit fast. We have a lot of stuff to do, and I don't want this tutorial to be like 40 minutes. So we're going to hook up the noise texture into the vector of the Voronoi, and we're going to put the Voronoi into the displacement. You know, we're going to add that diffuse back in for the time being so we can see what we're doing a little bit better. So we're going to add that back in, and now what we have is this. We already have a really, really bumpy texture. That's already pretty cool. Now we have our cool-looking texture, but it doesn't really look like rocks right now. It just looks like some weird... Actually, it could look like a sci-fi rock. If you're going for a sci-fi rock, you're done. But that's not what we're doing. So we're going to change around a couple of these settings. First things first, we're going to go... into not texture, material. We're gonna go in material mode so we can get a bit more frames, and we're gonna turn that scale down, or no, not that far down. Ooh, to like 2. Turn it down to like 2. That looks pretty good. And we're gonna mess around with our noise. Our noise, we're gonna turn that up to like 14, maybe less than 14, maybe 9. 9 is pretty good. Detail maybe to 5. Yeah, 5 looks good. And distortion, there's always good in a little number. 0.2. 0.2 looks good. Yeah, all right. So now we have a rocky texture, which is actually pretty good by itself. We could leave this exactly this way, and this could be a pretty good rocky texture if that's something you're going for. Instead of our sky texture, I might just make that like a solid black maybe. With our rocky texture... That looks pretty good. We could leave it like that, and it would be pretty good, but I want to do a little bit more to that. So what we're going to do is really we're done at this point, but I'm going to add a couple more things to this right now. So what we're going to do is in somewhere around here in geometry, in the little camera tab, which is the render tab in the main tab with our sphere, we're going to bump up the volume sampling to the step size to 0.5. Yeah, why not? 0.5 looks good, and the max steps we're gonna turn to 1200. Yeah, that's pretty good. All right, so that was pretty good, and that is pretty much done. You have infinite possibilities, really, what you can do. I'd recommend just to stick with the noise in Voronoi. So I mean, that is that. I hope you guys learned something new today. If you did, make sure to let me know down in the comment section. I love hearing from you guys. What should the next tutorial be? Let me know down in the comment section what you guys want to see. I'll see you guys in the next tutorial. But until then, bye.